On with Randy Moss, who the Patriots quarterback credits with New England's unbeaten start. It's not him. Plus, with Lamar Jackson breaking records by the start, Ryan Clark on how far the second-year quarterback can take this team. SportsCenter, coast to coast with me and Kerry Champion here on ESPN. And now back to First Take.
Three-time Super Bowl champ and NFL Network analyst, Michael Irvin. So good to have you with us. I don't know if you've
always
ever
fun.
Seen the show, but we play a little game. It's called Take It or Leave It.
Take It or Leave It.
Yeah, so I'm going to give you some headlines from yesterday. We'll start with Stephen A. here, and you guys tell me whether you're taking the statement or you're leaving it. Let's start with the L.A. teams. The Rams picking up a big win over the struggling Falcons. Stephen A., are you taking it or leaving it that the Rams are Super Bowl contenders?
I'm leaving it because I got questions about Todd Gurley's health. And without Todd Gurley being healthy, you have to rely on Jared Goff more. And I don't think that Jared Goff is reliable without the excellent services of a Todd Gurley.
I'm going to take it because I think Todd Gurley is a chance he could be healthy by the end, but come playoff time. And I think they could have a good enough record to make the playoffs. Well, and now that they have Ramsey in the secondary, that defense should be a lot better. Play action is the key. Like, when you have Todd Gurley with Jared Goff, he's a different quarterback.
Right.
And if they can get him healthy, they can make a run.
But now, we have seen nothing that will say he's going to get healthy. And in this league, in all my years of watching, it's you don't get better as the year goes on. You usually wear down a little bit as the year goes on. So I have to leave it also, just because of Todd Gurley.
By the way, Ramsey's a monster.
Yeah, he's
a monster.
Yeah, he is.
No question.
He's a beast, man.
Right, a beast.
All right, this next one I take no pleasure in asking. Max, the Chargers lose a heartbreaker to Tennessee. They're now 2-5. Take it or leave it, Phillip Rivers will never win a Super Bowl.
I take it. I'm off Phillip Rivers. I rooted for him for so many years because Roethlisberger and Eli both got to Super Bowls, and he's in that same draft class, and he was so good for so long, and kind of like Schottenheimer as a coach for that team originally, like I felt had a little bit of a bad rap, you know? No, man, he has not played with the chips on the line, including at Foxborough last year. Man. Even when the team is good, I'm going to take he never makes a Super Bowl.
I'm going to take it as well, and my condolences to Melvin Gordon with that fumble. I don't wish that on anybody, but I'll tell you this. Phillip Rivers is immobile. He's older. The Los Angeles Chargers, they're not an elite team. They're good enough to make things interesting, but they just don't have that one electrifying presence to take you over the hump. I don't see it happening. I'll take it.
We have come over a hump where we need to pull back on building around Phillip Rivers and build a team around that he can use to get to a Super Bowl. His way of getting to the Super Bowl, you build a great defense and a run game, and you say, hey, don't mess this up. Just get us in the right place. Sort of what Denver did the last year with Peyton Manning. That's how Phillip Rivers gets his Super Bowl. He's not going to throw you to a championship.
All right, next one here, guys. The Niners remain unbeaten. It was an ugly one against Washington. I'll start with you here, Michael. Take it or leave it.
I love the Niners.
San Francisco, this is going to be a tough one for you, will play in the NFC Championship game.
Boy, you got – hey, listen, I can take that.
What do you love about them?
Man, this is – for me, this is the best run game and the best head coach run game design I see in the National Football League. And he has taken a group of guys, and they believe in each other. I was watching that game the other day in the rain. Let me tell you something. I always talk about physical skill set, shoulders down, but the way somebody sees it and the way somebody feels about a team is huge. And you can see that San Francisco team coming together now and loving on each other. I got George Kittle and back of Jimmy G playing while he's doing interviews. Yep. Things like that go a long way in the locker room. I take the Niners, man.
Well, porn star Jimmy is a magnet. We understand that. I will tell you this, however. I'm taking it because I'm looking at that defense. That defense is real. They get at the passer and they cover. And those two things neutralize a lot of people, and it gives that running game more opportunities to excel. I'm going to take the 49ers.
No doubt you're both.
Did you call that man a porn star, Jimmy?
No, no. I didn't call him a porn star, but I call him porn star, Jimmy, because of who he was in Hollywood with.
By the way, you're both right about the run game and the defense and the way that goes together, but I want to say something about Jimmy G. I want to say something about Jimmy G, and that's why I'll take it, too. Belichick liked him so much, he wanted to move on from Tom Brady. Shanahan, look what happened to the Atlanta offense when he left, liked him so much. He gave all that money. And just like he was 7-0 to start his career, he's 6-0 right now. Boy, some of the best football minds look at that dude and say, I want him to be the quarterback. And the way he responds is by not losing any games.
Fine, but he ain't the reason they're winning. It's that defense.
Okay. Yeah. But there's a reason Belichick wanted him and Shanahan wanted him.
Serious, man. And that ring, they got some better. Yeah. George Kittle ain't no joke, man.
Yeah, Kittle's special.
No, they're real good. And that defense is playing so well. And talking about Bill's former quarterbacks, Jacoby Brissett looks pretty good, too. We'll talk to that in a minute. We'll get to that in just a second. So the Bills survive against the winless Dolphins. Guys, they only have one loss. It's at home to the Patriots. And if you remember that game, Josh Allen got hurt in that one, and it felt like the Bills could have won it. Take it or leave it, Max. Are the Bills overrated?
I'm going to take it. They have a great defense. I love the Bills' defense. I'm sorry. Much like we're talking about with Trubisky and some others, I don't believe in Josh Allen. Like, I just don't buy it. So I'm gonna take it.
I'm going to leave it, and here's why I'm going to leave it by default. When you look at New England, they're not what they used to be offensively. When you look at Indianapolis, even though we got to give Jacoby Brissett props, the bottom line is we know what they would have been with Andrew Luck. When we look at Houston, Bill O'Brien up and down. When we look at the AFC West, the Chiefs and their defense, the fact that the Bills have an elite defense is going to keep them in every game, and that's why I say leave it.
I'm a builder of hope, and I want to spread hope here for Buffalo, man, and I like what I see. Even though Buffalo hasn't played anybody, I mean nobody. They played nobody. But so I want to see more out of them. But I am a builder of hope. I'm going to have to leave it for now.
Yeah, this when you have a quarterback like that, you got to do what Lamar Jackson is doing now to start turning me around. Like, if you have that kind of – he's fat. The big thing is he has a big arm and he's fast. Okay, now I need to see some evidence on the field that you can read defenses and be accurate.
All right, we mentioned Jacoby Brissett. He lit up that Texans defense yesterday. They're atop of the AFC South. He's looking really impressive. Michael, take it or leave it, the Colts are a legit Super Bowl threat.
I think the Colts are a threat to any team they play against because of what they've overcome. And listen, to get that late news about Andrew Luck not playing, stick in Jacoby Brissett, give him a new contract, and build him as the man, Frank Wright, that's an incredible job. You don't do stuff like that in the National Football League and have this kind of success overcoming those kinds of obstacles.
And the difference between Bridgewater, well, maybe Max, there's not. Brissett is an ascending young quarterback.
Max, I was okay, Max. I don't know how you're going to put them in front of the Cowboys on roster, on what you see on a roster from 1-53.
Who's the Dallas backup quarterback?
Oh, my God, man. But you know.
That's what I'm talking about.
1-53. You didn't say the backup quarterback.
No, but what I'm saying is 1-53.
The roster.
The backup quarterback is an incredibly important position.
You know what? First of all, there's a couple of things. I don't like your tone. Number two, when I watch you on Sunday mornings on the NFL Network, I don't see you going at Mariucci and Kurt Warner and like that. You're going to come on this show, and you're going to come at me like that. Maybe
don't
I
have
should
any
come
Super
up there
on we don't have any
and get a jaw. Maybe that's what needs to happen. What's up with that? You show your respect.
I'm just saying, y'all talking about 1 to 53. Like
the Cowboys aren't in
you got the 1 through 22. Where's the 1 through 53?
Oh, my God, man. You Cowboys, know? Oh, top to bottom?
They got a lot of talent on paper.
Maybe only.
1 through 22, I agree with you.
I'm going to watch your crew, too, because a matter of fact, come to think of it, I think those brothers you work with there have been a little bit too nice to you. I think they've been letting you get away with a lot of gibberish about your Cowboys.
Man, let me get away with nothing.
Gibberish. That's what they've been doing. Away with. All of them. They'll call it all. Rich Eisen gonna show up in the house eventually too. Now you understand what I'm saying? I mean, your crew. Let me tell you something right now. I watch y'all all the time. I don't like the lack of respect. They need to be getting on you about the damn Cowboys. I'm telling you that right now.
All we're doing is educating and entertaining. That's what we do. That's what we
or
do.
Or entertaining, if you will.
Right.
Entertaining. KRS-One back. It's like
hooked on phonics. You're having so much fun, but you're learning. Oh, you walk out smart.
How about that reference?
Hooked on phonics.
That's a throwback. Patriots. We got football tonight. Monday Night Football right here on ESPN. Patriots are nearly 10-point favorites on the road at the Meadowlands on Monday Night Football. Max, take it or leave it. The Jets and Sam Darnold will cover the spread.
Leave it. I think the Patriots are going to – the Patriots' defense is something else this year, and I like the Patriots big in that one, even though the Jets played well.
What's the spread?
Recently.
10-point.
Ooh. Mm. It's a good call here.
I'm going to leave it. I'm thinking the Jets are going to lose by less than that.
Okay.
Yeah. Let me tell you something now. This is an emotional turn. That was a big win for the Jets when they played the Cowboys. Mm-hmm. Now to come back and line up against the Patriots – I don't think they cover.
Saying Jason Garrett, right. We're talking about this. Bill Belichick.
Michael Wilbon will be here exactly tomorrow. Miles Brown of Blackish. Thank you so much for being here.
I'm showing up on the NFL Network.
I'm
showing up on the NFL Network. I'm invading.
Wait, guys, we have one more. Take it or leave it. Starting with Stephen A. Cowboys make it to the Super Bowl.
Hell no! Leave it alone. Ain't happening.
Michael,
get that out.
I have many homes in Florida. If y'all need a room, call me. Just